But the lead story on center stage tonight. Delhi's Sushruta Trauma Center in the national capital has turned into a hospital of horrors. On Tuesday, the oxygen supply shut down at 6:40 in the morning in the intensive care unit at the center and reportedly could not be restored for 30 full minutes. This delay allegedly led to the death of 5 patients. It is believed that the hospital administration was fully aware of this problem, as it had been a recurring one. The Delhi police have filed an FIR, and the Delhi government has set up a special 3-member panel to probe this absolute horror and tragedy.
कि एक एजेंसी रखी गई थी जो कि ऑक्सीजन सप्लाई करती थी, साथ में हर चीज को मेंटेन करती थी, तो उसमें जो है फॉल्ट आया है उसके लिए हमने एक कमेटी बनाई है जिसमें हमारे स्पेशल सेक्रेटरी हैं और साथ में दो सीनियर एनेस्थेटिस्ट हैं, एचओडी जीवी पंत हॉस्पिटल, एचओडी एनेस्थीजिया जीटीबी हॉस्पिटल। तो इन तीनों की कमेटी जो है इसको टोटल एग्जामिन कर रही है, उसमें जहां पे भी जिसकी गलती होगी उस पर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी फिक्स की जाएगी, क्योंकि ये बड़ी दुख की बात है कि ऐसे इंसिडेंट्स हो, जबकि इन एजेंसीज को बड़ी हैवी पेमेंट जो है दिल्ली सरकार करती है, हॉस्पिटल की तरफ से रेगुलर पेमेंट की जाती है। तो मैं उम्मीद करता हूं कि 2 दिन में रिपोर्ट आ जाएगी। मैं ये कहना चाहूंगा कि जो भी मेडिकल सुपरिटेंडेंट्स हैं, इंचार्ज हैं, या जो जैसे ओटी के इंचार्ज हैं या आईसीयू के इंचार्ज हैं, उनको हर चीज पर नजर रखनी चाहिए कि और क्या क्या चीजें ऐसी हो सकती हैं जिसके कारण दिक्कत आ सकती है, तो उन सबको जो है कॉन्स्टेंटली वॉच करना चाहिए।
The Delhi government has announced compensation to the families of the deceased, but they want action and justice for the untimely loss of those precious lives.
We are looking into all aspects, whether it is human failure, or it is mechanical failure, or it is some issue of operation or management. All issues we are looking into. Committee had yesterday visited this spot. 3-4 घंटे हमने पूरी सारी चीजों को देखा। अभी सुबह में भी विथ आवर एक्सपर्ट्स वी हैव कम एंड वी हैव विजिटेड एंड नाउ वी आर सपोज टू वी हैव बीन आस्क्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट टू गिव रिपोर्ट बाय टुमारो।
तो कल तक तो ठीक थी, आज सुबह भी ठीक थी, कल ऑक्सीजन वगैरह नहीं मिला कोई।
तो ये बात आई थी सामने ऑक्सीजन की कमी,
तो बता ही नहीं रहा कोई, बताएगा कौन, अंदर तो जाने नहीं देते ना।
लेकिन इस तरह की बात सामने आई है।
हाँ सुना है, ऑक्सीजन खत्म है हॉस्पिटल में।
ऑक्सीजन की वजह से परसों तक भी ठीक थी, परसों तो बोल भी रही थी, कल नली डाल दी थी मुंह में, तो आज खत्म हो गई 1 घंटे पहले। पता नहीं, हम सब तो बाहर थे, अंदर तो जाने नहीं दे रहे थे।
3 बजे करीब में इनकी हालत बिगड़ गई थी, उसके बाद में डॉक्टरों ने इन्हें सांस पांच दे के जो इन्हें रोका गया था अब तक। उस टाइम पे इन्होंने समझ लिया गैस इनके जो बिल्कुल जो ये धड़कन बिल्कुल बंद हो चुकी थी, जिस टाइम ऑक्सीजन की जो कमी आई है उस टाइम धड़कन बिल्कुल बंद हो चुकी थी। उसके बाद में फिर इन लोगों ने जो ये दाब दूब के जो धड़कन लाए थोड़ी बहुत।
Well, joining me on center stage this evening is Delhi's Health Minister AK Walia to take some hard questions. Mr. Walia, 4 critically ill patients have died at this government-run hospital in Delhi today, allegedly after their oxygen supply was cut off for several minutes. Who do you as Health Minister think is responsible for this criminal negligence?
Basically, this intensive care unit, the supply was outsourced. A private contractor was put there who was supposed to maintain everything. What I understand up till now is there were definitely disruption in the supply of the oxygen, but the exact cause will be known after the inquiry is completed. We had set an inquiry under our special secretary and 2 senior anesthetists also, which had gone there. They had made all the inquiries and will be submitting us the report tomorrow. So after that, everything will be clear.
Mr. Walia, the information that we have is that there was actually a drop in oxygen pressure at around 2 a.m. on Tuesday. It was rectified, but the problem actually recurred at around 6:45 a.m. Doesn't this actually prove that despite getting early signs that there was a serious problem and it wasn't resolved even then, and that has led to these deaths, it's a clear case of negligence, not just by those outsourced parties, but the hospital authorities as well, and they come under your command?
Definitely, there was a drop in the oxygen supply. It was restored, and again at 6:40, this thing occurred. So that's why we want to fix the responsibility, because it was their duty, it was the duty of the company which is maintaining the oxygen supply, that everything should have been taken care of. So, and the other peoples also who were around, it was their duty also to see that whatsoever the fault was there, that should have been corrected immediately.
Well, Mr. Walia, authorities at the hospital have pinned the blame on the private company which runs this oxygen supply facility there. They claim that the latter had failed to provide enough backup cylinders to actually stabilize the supply. But haven't hospital authorities too failed to monitor the supply and rectify the problem? Shouldn't they be prosecuted? It's all very easy to blame it on some external agency which you have vetted, which you have certified and validated enough to actually allow them to do business with the state-run hospital. You can't just throw them to the wind without taking some of the blame yourself.
Basically, cylinders were there, oxygen was also available, but the there were 11 cylinders on one side and 10 cylinders on the other side, and normally all the cylinders are connected. The person who was posted there, he kept on connecting one cylinder, and when it was finished, another cylinder was connected. That was the main cause of the problem. So, as the report is there, and against whomsoever the negligence is found, now we'll be taking action against them.
Well, you're talking about the action that's going to be taken. A committee has been formed to actually investigate this tragedy, Mr. Walia. But you're a minister of the Congress party, which has a precedent that Lal Bahadur Shastri, you know, he offered his resignation as the Union Railway Minister hours after he was made aware of a train accident that killed around 150 people many years ago. Should you not take the moral responsibility for these deaths and step down while this inquiry is complete?
You see, practically, Delhi, we have about 22,000 beds, and lakhs of patients come to Delhi. And we try our best to provide all the facilities. And in this case also, whosoever has made the mistake will be punished.
A.K. Walia, thanks for speaking to Headlines today. You haven't really answered many of the questions that we have for you. You're saying that procedures will go through as far as inquiring into what went wrong. But it appears that the Delhi government has already made up its mind on how it wants to actually deal with the situation. They'd like to just cut this private enterprise loose and blame it all on the company that was actually roped in from the private sector to make those oxygen cylinders available in that hospital. But the Delhi government, make no mistake, must take a large part of the blame for what has happened today.